Tiger was a bravo cat who traveled on a barge. In fact, he was the roughest cat that ever roamed at large.
From Gravesend up to Oxford, he pursued his evil aims, rejoicing in the title of
the Terror of the Thames.
His manner and appearance did not calculate to please. His coat was torn and seedy, he was baggy at the knees.
One ear was somewhat missing, no need to tell you why. And he scowled upon a hostile world from one forbidding eye.
The cottagers at Rotherhithe knew something of his fame. At Hammersmith and Putney, people shuddered at his name.
They would fortify the hen house, lock up the silly goose.
When the rumor ran along the shore,
Growltiger's on the loose!
Woe to the weak canary that fluttered from its cage!
Woe to the pampered pekingese that face Growltiger's rage.
Woe to the bristly bandicoot that lurks on foreign ships.
And woe to any cat with whom Growltiger came to grips.
But most to cats of foreign race his hatred has been vowed. To cats of foreign name and race no quarter was allowed. The Persians and the Siamese regarded him with fear, because it was a Siamese, had mauled his missing ear. Now on a peaceful summer night, all nature seemed at play. The tender moon was shining bright, the barge at Molesey. All in the balmy moonlight it lay rocking on the tide, and Growltiger was disposed to show his sentimental side.
Chi-la,
mi amore.
Da notte d'estate, allor che la natura era nel pieno fulgore e la fresca rugiada splendeva il chiar di luna sopra la verzura, si poteva vedere il
Oh, si là in silenzio del vento profumato, dalla marea del naviglio serenamente culato, in quella tepida notte che c'è dunque di male, se in tanta poesia il pirata diventa un sentimento.
Oscillare in silenzio nel vento profumato, dalla marea del naviglio serenamente colato, e in quella tepida notte, in quella tepida notte.
Genghis gave the signal to his fierce Mongolian horde. Abandoning their sampans, the chinks they swarmed aboard. Abandoning their sampans, their pullaways and junks, they battened down the hatches on the crew within their bunks. Then Griddle Bone, she gave a screech, for she was badly scared. I'm sorry to admit it, but she quickly disappeared.
She probably escaped with ease. I'm sure she was not drowned.
But a silly dream of flashing steel, Growltiger had its around.
These modern productions are all very well, but there's nothing to equal from what I hear till that moment of mystery when I made history.